My name is Susan Wallace. I am 33. When I was 23, I was in a motor vehicular accident and I sustained a brain injury. I was the passenger. Cindy that day passed away, and she passed away on May 22nd, 2009. I remember waking up and I saw the nurse and I was like, am I late for work? And she said, you haven't been to work in 30 days. And I was in the coma for 6 weeks. One thing that I have to relearn and will never ever be single is my vision. I will always have double vision for the rest of my life. I have a lot of limitations. Sleeping, speech, what I have to struggle with life is relationships. It's all about the trust issue. Back when I had the accident, they had told my parents not to tell me that the driver, Cindy Villacourt-Jernes, passed away. So all that hope and, oh, I can't wait to see her, she's gonna wake up, all that hope was smashed basically when they gave me the newspaper and showed me she had passed. When you go out with someone to a bar and you have all these good times with this person and you work with this person, you don't expect to hear the words, they pass. She was only 21. She was a baby, barely starting off life. I start to think it's unreal, like that's unbelievable. I survived that. So in my eyes, Cindy saved me because she went over and hit me and knocked me unconscious. We tried him for murder. This was the second DUI. I don't remember, so I have to take all these pills. I want to live, so I have to take these pills and, but where is that getting me? And that's where I'm at right now. Like, in my end, I feel like there's gonna be no justice. There's no such thing. Once someone passes away, where's the justice? Because you can't bring it back. So there's no justice. You could put someone in jail forever. Where's the justice? I'm not happy. I'm stuck with this for life. This injury is for life. This is not a month, a week, it's for life. That hurts me the most. I didn't get to go to her funeral. Everyone says, Susie, you were in a coma. It doesn't matter. I like to go to everyone's funeral, say me goodbyes. But she saved me, she was everything. But I couldn't say goodbye. And I think that lives with me and hurts me. Because I feel like everyone got to say goodbye, and I didn't. This is the hardest thing that a person can go through, and it makes you really look at disabilities and disability people a different way, deaf culture, people that are in wheelchairs. It makes you look. And what I admire is now being injured, I can see, share my story with everyone. Because I'm gonna tell you, it's a struggle. It's a struggle. And I would love to be a guest speaker. That's one of my goals in life. Because when you're disabled, it is you want to be better. You want to be quote unquote normal of the world. So you work hard and you try hard. And I want to be that person that people look up and go, she's injured and she did it.